Okay, what we got here, we're almost done taping it off. And what I'm going to do is it's called back taping. What you want to do is the area that you're going to prime, you want to cover it with your paper and go past where you stop sanding it with your 180, see? And then go ahead and cover that up. This is after you already outlined everything. And then fold it back. Now what that's going to do, that's going to give us a soft edge. That's going to give us a soft edge down there. So when we go to sand it, it's not going to have a real sharp edge, but it'll all blend in perfect. Now here's a good example. This is the place that I'm going to prime. I'm going to put my paper where it's actually covering it. And if you look right in this area, you'll see, okay, where I stopped sanding. So I'm going to come back to where I stopped sanding. See how I'm doing that, Charlie? Are you learning anything?
Yep.
Okay. And then I'm going to fold it back. And if you see right there, now it's got a soft edge instead of a hard edge. So when I sand that, it'll be a lot faster, easier, and quicker to do. I'm gonna mix the primer up, I'm gonna prime it. I gotta put 3 full wet coats on this because this is a very rough texture. And we had to do it that rough just to get rid of all the... on this little fix repair we got going is Ultra High Build 2K Primer, okay? Now that's a 2K primer which requires a hardener to activate the primer. This doesn't require no reducer, nothing, okay? And we're gonna go ahead and mix our primer. Always use a strainer for your spray gun. Over here, Charlie, can you see that?
Yep.
Okay, I'm not mixing up a lot of primer because we don't have a lot of space to prime. What we're going to do, we're going to go in there. And I'm going to use very low pressure on this because I want more paint to go on than air, see? And I got my little buddy sitting there waiting for me. What's up, buddy? Set my pressure down. This is a very small area, so we're going to go ahead and set that down. Now, if you watch right in this area here, you're going to see, let me go ahead, can you see that?
Yep.
Okay, that's because I sanded that with 80 grit. And this is plastic, okay? Now watch the rest of it. If you look, you can you see that?
Yep.
It looks rough, it looks like it's got texture, okay?
Yep.
That's why that requires, can you see me, Charlie? You can now, right?
Yeah.
That's why that requires 3 to 4 very full wet coats of primer to fill. Now I'm going to go ahead and put it on very full and wet. If you can see that. You see what I'm saying, Charlie?
Yep.
Flip that switch up there, Charlie. Right there on the wall. And if you notice, the primer is filling in the roughness. You see what I'm saying, Charlie?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we're going to come back, we're going to prime that again. And see, a lot of people, now, I have told you I'm doing this job in a 2-stage job, am I right?
Yeah.
And I guarantee you now, what's going to happen, the lady's going to pick up her car because she's going to bring it back next week to paint it. And she's going to look at it and say, oh my God, that looks worse than before I brought it to you. Oh my God, do you know what the fuck you're even doing here? Do you see what I'm trying to say, Charlie?
Yeah.
Okay? Because she doesn't know, see? That's the situation you have, and that's why I'm here to show you, okay? That's why my friend Pete is showing you how this is done and how you can actually do it at home. Okay, does that make sense, Charlie?
Yeah.
Does that make sense, Bruno? Come here. Come up. Come here. Get over here, you little fat boy. Check it out when it's all primed. I'll show you the situation we have. And I guess in a week or so, when she brings it back, we'll show you how to paint it. Okay, what I did, I went ahead went ahead and primed it, but I don't think the lady that owns the van, I mean the car, whatever the fuck it is, she ain't gonna fucking understand what the hell's going on when she sees her car looking like shit. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So what I'm doing in there, I'm force drying it. I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand with 400, then I'll put one more coat of primer on it, look like brand new, see? You understand what I'm saying, Charlie?
Yep.
So come on in here. And what I got here, I got my heater down here, actually force drying now. And if you look at it right here where the light's in, you can see how rough that looks, Charlie. Can you see that? Zoom in on it. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Watch the fucking heater with my camera, bud. See, that's what I'm saying. If the lady sees that, she's probably gonna go, oh my God, it looks worse than when I brought it here, rah, rah, rah. Because she doesn't understand that this is what the situation is. So now I gotta fucking fix that, you know, it's a fucking joke is what it is. Now, like I said, I force dried that, okay, with my heater. Now what I'm gonna do to cool it down, I'm gonna take my air hose, because I still got my primer mixed up and I gotta hurry before the primer actually hardens. Right here, Charlie. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand that. And I'm trying to get this done because I have primer in my gun, okay? And once that primer is activated with the hardener, you're kind of screwed. So what I'm doing, I'm just sanding that down, okay, because I want to get that rough look out of it, see? Because, you know, people don't really realize what it takes to fix a car, bud. And like I said, once this is all sanded, block sanded, painted, it'll look like brand new, but to get the mistakes out that she had in her car, this is basically the only way that you can fix it. Now, if you look at that, you can see that it's actually getting smoother. Can you see that, Charlie? Okay. So that's all I'm doing. I'm just taking out the rough shit. Cause I don't want this lady, you know, freaking out on us, bud. We definitely don't need another one of them fucking jobs in here. So just cause it looks rough when you prime it, doesn't mean it's gonna stay that way. Once it dries and you go to wet sand it, all that will go away. What I'm doing is I'm filling in all that roughness from DA sanding it. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yep.
Okay, let me get that sanded. We're gonna reprime it and we'll come back and get a final look at it and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So, I got that sanded. I'm gonna go ahead and squirt the rest of my primer on there if it hasn't dried up in my spray gun. Let's see what happens. Okay, we still got it. I can hear it shaking. And flip that fan over there, Charlie. Now, while it's still tacky and wet, what I do, right there, Charlie. Do you remember what that's called, Charlie? What's that called? I gave you a name for it. I'm up here, bud, not down here.
Guide coat.
Exactly. Always want to put a guide coat before you pull your paper off, see? That way you don't get it all over the car, bud. See there? If I could only get $1,500 for a little repair like that, I'd be a rich motherfucker. I don't know how these big shops do it. I don't know how they do it, Charlie. If I charge somebody something like that, they'd say, get the fuck out of here. Am I right?
Yeah.
I mean, what the fuck, man? Some people got all the luck, but you know what? Money ain't everything in life, dude. Okay? Remember that. Get a good look at it over here, Charlie. That's the light. Come around here, Charlie. Camera guy Charlie's learning. Then you pan it back up and around over to my face, see? This is Pete. We just fixed a quick fix. You can do this in your driveway at home. Don't pay the high prices. Don't fucking go to the big exotic bullshit paint and body shop that's gonna take the stick, you know, and stick it in your fucking ass.
I don't understand. What the hell's the situation over here? I mean, goddamn, son of a bitch, bastard cocksucker.